starring June Lockhart, Hugh Riley, John Provost as Timmy, and, of course, Lassie.
Look, that's Mr. Cully. Boy, look at him come. Mom, Dad, here comes Mr. Cully. Boy, is he in a hurry.
Paul, something's happened. I know it.
Well, we trying to blow that thing up?
Cully, what is it? What's happened?
It ain't what has happened. It's what's gonna happen. Did you see this?
Calverton Centennial Celebration. Special event. Wild burro race.
Yep.
Get in the fun. Race a burro for the money. Wild burros directly off the plains of Nevada. Entry fee $25, win $175 first place money or $75 for second. Claim your entry while they last. Hurry, hurry, hurry. So?
So I'm gonna race me one of them little fellas and I'm gonna win me that $175 first prize. Now what do you think of that?
I think you better come in and have a cup of coffee and talk it over.
No, no, there ain't nothing to talk over. My mind's made up, it is. I'm gonna race and I'm gonna win her. Ooh, I can just see myself. I can just... Come on. Come on, burro, let's go. Oh, let's go for the money. Oh, I'm gonna win it.
Well, I'll drink to that. Come on in, Collie. Let's have some coffee.
Yeah.
A wild burro race.
Now, $150 is exactly what I need to make a down payment in that 5 acres of land adjoining mine. See? And I want to get it before that land-hungry Krebs, my next-door neighbor, gets his hands on it.
Sure.
Now, you subtract that $150 from the $175 first prize, and I still get $25 left over. Which, of course, will pay for my entry fee.
Wait a minute, Cully. You can't pay an entry fee on money you haven't got, and chances are won't win.
Well, now, that's exactly what I come to talk to you about. Now, if you could see a way clear to let me have the land of that $25, I'd pay you back just as soon as I win my prize money. Sounds all right?
No. No, it sounds all wrong. In the first place, Cully, I haven't got the money to spare. And even if I did have it, I couldn't take $25 and just throw it down the drain.
What do you mean, throw it down the drain?
Oh, look, Cully, you know as well as I do that burros, especially wild ones, are the hardest animals to handle. Why, they're the orneriest and most stubborn little beasts in the whole world.
Yeah, well, let me tell you something, Paul Martin. The good Lord saw fit to ride in one. And that makes a burro, in my opinion, one of God's noblest creatures. Besides, it seems darn funny to me when a fellow's best friend won't give a hand to help an old man get the chance he's been dreaming of for most half his life.
Oh, Cully.
Please, Dad. Can't we?
Thanks, Timmy. You too, Lassie.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
Oh, well, now look. There must be something we could do, some way we could help.
That land means an awful lot to me.
I've got $3.54 in my piggy bank.
Now, that's a start. Oh, that's a good start, ain't it, folks?
Oh, now, I have some money put away here in my rainy day fund. Let's see now. It's, about $7.18 here. If it's all right with you, Paul, I'd just love to lend it to Cully.
Bless you, Ruth. Bless you.
Now, let's see. That's a... $3.54 and $7.18. That makes some...
$10.78.
No, Mr. Cully. $10.72.
That's right, Timmy. $10.72. That's $14.38 were minus.
No, Mr. Cully.
$14.28.
But, $25. That's right. All we need now is $14.28.
All we need now? How much money have you got to add to this?
Well, Paul, that's just the trouble. I ain't got me a dime. That is, until after the race, of course.
Of course.
Come on, Paul. Couldn't you help us out?
Dad?
All right, that beats me. There's 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 25, 26, 27, 28, and good luck.
Thanks, Paul. Come on, Timmy, we got us a little burro to pick out.
Hooray! Come on, Lassie. Okay, Mom and Dad?
Yes, okay, Timmy. And pick out a good one, please.
Okay.
By the way, something else. I was sort of wondering if you could see your way clear to let me have the land of your pickup truck to bring the little fella back home in.
Sure. Sure.
Thanks, Paul. You can use my pickup truck meanwhile. Come on, Timmy.
Come on, Lassie.
Timmy. Look. That double-dealing, land-hungry neighbor of mine, Matt Krebs. He stole my idea. He's after that land. I know you see me. I know it.
Mr. Cully.
No, don't you worry. Don't worry. We'll pick us a winner.
Howdy. What can I do for you?
Howdy. You the fella in charge here?
That's right.
Well, we're here to pick us out a burro. We'd like to look them all over.
Well, that won't take long. There she is.
She?
That's right. That's the only one left.
She ain't very much to look at now, is she?
Maybe if we clean her up a little, she'll look better.
No. Bathing ain't gonna do that thing no good.
If I were you, I wouldn't judge by appearances. Queenie's got a lot of spirit, I'll guarantee it.
Queenie, huh? That's your name, huh?
Mr. Cully, wait. You stay here, Lassie. I don't know, Mr. Cully. She looks awful tired to me.
She has spirit, hasn't she?
What'd I tell you?
I'll take her, Mr. Banner. Mr. Banner, yeah. My name's Collie. Collie Wilson. Here's the $25 entry fee, and I got some more here for you. Sorry about all the little change. Gee, Queenie. There, come on. Now, you better get out the way. I don't want to run over you. Take the box with you.
Okay, Mr. Cully.
Yeah. Now, get ready to jump. She might take off awful fast. All right, let's practice, Queenie. The man will say, ready, set, go. And when he says go, that's us. See? Come on. Ready, go. Come on, Queenie. Come on, Queenie. Giddy up.
Come on, Queenie. Come on, Queenie. Well, give her a little start, eh? Give her a little.
Knuckle-headed, no good bag of bones.
Lassie.
Well, thank you, Lassie. Thank you very much. Lassie, I heard you had ways with other animals. I never would believe it. Why, with your help, anybody could win that race. Hands down. Yeah. Hands down. Lassie, I'm going to reward you for what you've done for me. Yes, sir. I'm going to give you something real nice. Come along, gal. And that do it? Here's a lot of it. Well, all fair in love and war, and burro races.
Come on, come on. Let's get going, Queenie. Today is a big day. Come on, Timmy. Come on, Queenie, up, up. Now, come on. You've been doing fine up to now. This is no time to get stubborn. Come on, up, up. Hi, Timmy.
Hi, Mr. Cully. You about ready to go?
Well, just about. As soon as I get this animal up there. Come on.
Where's Lassie?
What do you mean, where's Lassie? I thought she went home to get you.
No, she didn't come home. I didn't pass her on the road. I bet she took the shortcut. I better go home and get her.
Hi, neighbor! Hope you make it!
May believe you don't hear him.
Come on, we ain't got much time. The race starts in an hour. Come on, give me a hand, will you?
Mom and Dad were about to leave, so they'll probably bring Lassie.
Come on, go, darn you. We gotta be first over that finish line.
We're lucky if we get her up to the starting line.
Yeah.
Sure needs Lassie.
Yeah, Timmy, you take the rope. You pull, I'll push.
Okay, Mr. Collie.
What's the matter, neighbor? Having a little trouble?
No, I ain't having a little trouble, neighbor.
I thought Lassie was going to help them with Queenie, but I don't see her. I better give them a hand.
Thank you, Paul.
Don't mention it, partner.
Looks like it's going to take one of you to ride them and the other two to push them. Is that so?
Well, good luck, partner.
We need it.
Well, it was a tough fight, Mom, but we made it.
All right, men. Get your burros up to the line. Get you up a little bit.
Now, let's get ready, Timmy.
That's good. We're all ready when you are.
Anytime now.
Now, you all know the course. In case there's any misunderstanding, I'll repeat it. Go straight down the road, across the bridge, back up the lower road, to the crossing, and back here to the finish line. Those of you who are riding, mount up. Those of you who are walking, get ready.
Ready, Timmy.
Ready, Mr. Cully.
I'm ready. Get set.
Goes our $25.
You mean there stands our $25?
Lassie!
Glory be! We ain't beat yet, Timmy.
Give me the rope, Mr. Cully.
Collie, it ain't fair.
What do you mean?
Mr. Banner, I claim foul. That dog ain't no jockey. Collie should have handled that burro himself.
Mr. Banner, I read the rules, and it doesn't say any place where the jockey has to be a person.
No, you see, that's right. That's right, ain't it, Mr. Banner?
Well, the boy's right, Mr. Krebs. I'm afraid we can't penalize the collie.
There, you see, you old fuddy-duddy.
Well, first prize, $175, Mr. Cully. Second prize, $75, Mr. Krebs.
Look at that money, will you? Timmy, look, look. Lassie, look. Well, I'm going to buy that land. And I'm going to make a good home for you too, Queenie. Forever.
Mr. Cully, you only rented the burro. You don't own her.
I don't.
No.
No. No, that's right, I don't. What would it cost to buy it?
Well, her price is $50.
$50? Well, I can't buy my land and buy Queenie, too.
I was wondering, maybe if there wouldn't be no objection if we bought that land together. $75 apiece, 2.5 acres each. That way, you could buy Queenie, too. That is, if you could consider being partners after what I'd done to you.
What did you done to me? Dead to me. Dead. What did you do to me?
Well, I locked Lassie in my barn.
You locked Lassie? Well, I guess there ain't much to forgive her.
Well,
put it there, partner. It's a deal.
Yeah. I owe you $50, eh? 20, 40, 50.
Thank you.
Well, now I gotta get the little lady home. You wanna go home, Queenie?
You wanna go home?
Here we go. Let's go.
Come on, now don't get stubborn again. Come on, Queenie. Come on.
Nice, Queenie. Queenie, come on.